My dear students of class 9A and 9B, lesson number 4, the Mauryan Empire, already I have taught you, and only two paragraphs were to be taught, but we have decided to revise the lesson only for your conveniences. That's why the same lesson, lesson 4, the Mauryan Empire, I am going to revise from the beginning to the last. Then I shall introduce a new lesson for you. Now, first one, sources. You know, Kautilya wrote a famous book, a descriptive book about the reign of Chandragupta Maurya. Who established the Mauryan Empire? You know, Chandragupta Maurya established the Mauryan Empire. Who helped Chandragupta Maurya in establishing such a vast kingdom? It was Kautilya or Chanakya helped Chandragupta Maurya in establishing a vast kingdom, and ultimately he became the great king of India. So Kautilya's Arthashastra gives us a detailed information about the contemporary age of the Mauryan Empire. According to Arthashastra, there were 16 Mahajanapadas, and the time when Chandragupta Maurya could not establish such a strong kingdom, two kingdoms were ruling the country. Number one, Sisunagas, and number two, Nandas. So by, overthrowing the Nandas from power, Chandragupta Maurya established the Mauryan Empire, the vast empire over the period from 321 to 297 BCE, my dear students. And other sources, there are certain sources of the Mauryan Empire. Number one source, Kautilya's Arthashastra. Second source, Indica, written by Megasthenes. Third source, Visakhadatta's Mudra Rakshasa. And fourth source, Dipsamal Mahasamsa, the chronicles which were made by the writers of Silla. Now, Kautilya's Arthashastra gives us a detailed idea about the contemporary age, its social, political and economic condition, the condition of the people, the good system of administration, its education system, education system, growth of education, growth and development of the country under Chandragupta Maurya. Each and every point we come to know from the authentic book written by Kautilya Arthashastra. Indica, it was written by Megasthenes. Who was Megasthenes? You know, Megasthenes was an ambassador at the court of Chandragupta Maurya, sent by Seleucus Nicator. Seleucus Nicator sent Megasthenes to be an ambassador at the court of Chandragupta Maurya. So while staying in India, he wrote the famous book Indica. In that famous book, he also has given various informations about the reign of Chandragupta Maurya. Now Visakhadatta also has written about the age of Chandragupta Maurya. How did he overthrow the Nandas, and how was he helped by Chanakya or Kautilya? Each and every point Visakhadatta wrote in his drama, Visakhadatta's drama, was Mudra Rakshasa. And next, Dipasamba and Mahasamba, the Ceylonese Kritinam, the Ceylonese Chronicles also has helped us to reconstruct the history of the history of Ashoka also. Later on, I am going to discuss about Ashoka. What is Ashoka's edicts? Ashoka has introduced various types of edicts. There are 33 inscriptions on the pillars of Ashoka found out, which proved that during the age of Ashoka, the Ashoka's rule, the Ashoka's language he has chosen, and the system of religion, whatever he adopted, it was due to the growth and development of the Buddhist culture and its teachings and preachings. Ashoka was impressed and he introduced certain things from the concept of Buddhism, and he introduced his own edicts. That edicts are known as Ashokan edicts. There are 14 edicts and two separate ones found in Orisha. Major rock edicts, the Twin Edict, Barbar Gate inscription, Kandahar Bindiyan inscriptions, these all are the edicts, and besides, seven pillar edicts also are there, from where we come to know about the reign of Ashoka, Ashoka's achievements, Ashoka's policies, Ashoka's administration, his administrative policies. Each and every point we come to know from the edicts of Ashoka. Now, Ashoka, Dharma Vijaya, about that system, Ashoka also has given some informations in his edicts. Why did he change his policy of war? Earlier he was an aggressive ruler. He believed in the policy of aggression, he believed in the policy of violence, but later on he became a violent, non-violent ruler. And what was the reason behind it? Ashoka explained in his rock edicts. And from there we come to know about the reason, about the principle of Ashoka, why had he changed his policy of war. Later on, Ashoka established the great stupa, the Sanchi Stupa in Madhya Pradesh. It was due to Ashoka's belief, faith, respect for the concept Buddhism. Ashoka himself spent a lot of money for the construction of Sanchi Stupa, and surface of the wall of Sanchi Stupa, all the stories he had taken from the Jataka's stories, Jataka's tales, which were written about the previous life of Lord Buddha. Ashoka had taken it, and he also mentioned the moral themes, ethics, on the surface of the wall of the Sanchi Stupa. Since he was inspired by the concept of Buddhism, that's why he had taken it and got it engraved on the wall of Sanchi Stupa. Buddha has been represented in the form of symbols, like a wheel or throne placed under the peepal tree or lotus. The stupa shows the technical and the artistic skills and styles, and the artisans during the Mauryan period, the quality and skills of the artists also proved that they were patronized by Buddha, patronized by Emperor Ashoka, and hence they were able to prove their skills, their talents in the field of art and in the field of architecture. Now, Chandragupta Maurya, who was Chandragupta Maurya? Chandragupta Maurya was the founder ruler of Mauryan dynasty, as I told you earlier. Chandragupta Maurya, with the help of Kautilya, defeated the last ruler, Nandas, and established the Mauryan kingdom. And later on, he extended his empire in various parts of India and made a very vast area. He extended not only the areas with his kingdom by defeating different kings of India, but also he declared himself to be a powerful ruler of the Mauryan dynasty our country has ever produced. That's why, my dear students, it is due to the effort of Kautilya. Kautilya, who was Kautilya? Kautilya was not only a writer, Kautilya also was a critic, diplomat. Once he was insulted by the Nandas and was determined to take a revenge against that insult, he digested once upon a time. But later on, the time came, he decided to support Chandragupta Maurya and encouraged him to fight against the Nandas. Ultimately, the Nandas were defeated. Chandragupta fought bravely, fought like a great king, great, you know, leader, great, you know, great military general, and proved his qualities, his talents, his bravery with the help of Kautilya, and ultimately defeated the Nandas and established the Mauryan Empire. Chandragupta formed alliances with various kingdoms, like, you know, the Greek general Nicator, Seleucus Nicator came, because, you know, Seleucus Nicator was the general of Alexander the Great, but Alexander the Great suddenly felt ill, and that's why he decided to leave India. And the places where Alexander established his control, after the death of Alexander, Seleucus Nicator came back to India and decided to recapture that areas which were occupied by Alexander the Great. That's why Seleucus Nicator came back to India and faced Chandragupta Maurya. As soon as Alexander the Great died, the news reached, and Chandragupta Maurya occupied the areas once Alexander occupied. So that news reached Seleucus Nicator, hence he had to come India to recapture the areas or the places Alexander once occupied. So naturally, both of them fought against each other, but ultimately Chandragupta Maurya was able to defeat Seleucus Nicator. Seleucus Nicator was charmed to witness or to learn the ability of fighting or giving leadership, and hence he was impressed, and he handed over some areas like Hindar, like, you know, Afghanistan, and some other places where Alexander also had established his control. He handed over it to Chandragupta Maurya, and not only that, he also handed over his daughter's hand for Chandragupta Maurya. So Chandragupta Maurya married his daughter Helen, and ultimately there established a matrimonial relationship between Seleucus Nicator and Chandragupta Maurya. So the chapter was closed, and Seleucus Nicator got back to his own place, and later on Chandragupta Maurya, before his death, he decided to make his son Bindusara to be the ruler of the Mauryan dynasty. So Bindusara became the ruler of Mauryan dynasty, and proved to be an able successor of Chandragupta Maurya. So during his 32 years of reign, Bindusara not only held the empire together, but also stabilized and consolidated it, and extended its boundaries towards various parts of India, especially southern India. He maintained a good relations with Greeks, Syrians, and Egyptians, and introduced a system of international trade with foreign countries. And after Bindusara's death, you know, his son Ashoka came to the throne in 273 BCE. And then he is considered to be one of the greatest rulers in Indian history according to the Indian historians. So it is said that Bindusara's greatest contribution to Indian history was his son Ashoka. Next day we shall discuss about Ashoka and his contributions. Thank you, my dear students.